بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما وعملا يا كريم. All praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace and salutations be upon the final messenger Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Barakallahu feekum for your patience and your attendance. I just lectured for almost 8 hours, I think, this morning, from this morning till around 4:30 or 5 o'clock at Al-Muntada. We had a program there related to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for some reasons beyond our control, there was a delay getting here, but inshallah we'll try and release the subject matter before Salat al-Maghrib bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. The topic that has been passed on to me is the topic of istiqamah. And istiqamah in the Arabic language comes from the term istaqama yastaqimu istiqamatan. It's derived from the verb istiqamah. يَسْتَقِيمُ and إِسْتِقَامَةً is the root noun, the root form or the root noun, the مَصْدَر. And in the English language we would translate this term as being steadfast. Now إِسْتِقَامَة plays an integral part in our lives and has an integral placement in terms of the Sharia. And from that which makes us realize how important it is are the many ayat in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and many statements found in the sunnah related to istiqamah. From these is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in his book, in the greatest surah in the Quran, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاط الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. And this has been placed upon us as something that we recite every day in our salawat. And this ayah means, guide us to the straight path. Because this is istiqamah. Istiqamah, or steadfastness, refers to treading the established way. And this established way in the Sharia is the middle way. A way that exists between two extremes. Between two extremes. We have Sirat al-Mustaqim, the middle way. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has this ayah in Surah Al-Fatiha, the greatest surah in the Quran. Something that we recite every day. This is a dua where we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us steadfastness. So this fact alone should be enough in us understanding what an important concept istiqamah is and what an integral part it has in the Sharia and how important it is to us as Muslims and those who have declared the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and accepted the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From the points that make us understand how important istiqamah is, O servants of Allah and children of Adam, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to this concept, as well as those that follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتْ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to remain steadfast, as he has been commanded to remain steadfast. So being steadfast is from the commands that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And from that which makes us understand how important istiqamah is the fact that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us as well towards istiqamah. For he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saddidu waqaribu. Saddidu waqaribu. And saddidu refers to this concept of being steadfast, refers to always being upon the instruction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if we are unable, then at least we should be close to it. Thus he said, وَقَارِبُ. And this is from that which also makes us realize how important istiqamah is, for the Sharia has set a way next to istiqamah for those who try their best but have not managed yet to achieve istiqamah. So he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saddidu wa qaribu, that remain steadfast. And if you can't, then the next level is to try your best to be the closest to being steadfast. From that also, which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, which makes us appreciate how important istiqamah is in the hadith of Sufyan ibn Abdullah al-Thaqafi, when he said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say to me something specific to me that I will not ask anyone besides you, O Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ, that say, I have believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then become steadfast. And then become steadfast. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this also is from that which makes us understand how important istiqamah is, has set a way for us to turn back to Him. And a way for us to get back to istiqamah should we make a mistake and tread the path of retrogression. Thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that remain steadfast and be upon the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness. Forgiveness when? In case you make a mistake, for we are human beings. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا, that we are weak, we make mistakes, we are prone to error. But the path to istiqamah is always open when we fall off it. And that is through the process of istighfar and seeking forgiveness in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the greatest ways, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, that allows us to appreciate and understand how important istiqamah is by looking at the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set for the people who are steadfast. We look at the reward, and the reward teaches us as well the amount of effort that's required of us to achieve istiqamah. Because al-jaza' min jinsi al-amal, the reward is based upon the effort that has been rendered. And in management we always say that reward is proportional to effort. Reward is proportional to effort. So what is the reward for those of istiqamah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in ayat in the Quran that are beloved to us. We love to read it. And we love to hear the imam recite it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ, that indeed for those who say, رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ, Allah is our Rabb, ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, and then they became steadfast. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ, نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاؤُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نُزُلًا مِّنْ غَفُورٍ رَّحِيمٍ. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. What an amazing mention in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And indeed all the ayat in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are amazing. Let's discuss this ayah a little bit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ, that indeed for those who say our Rabb is Allah, ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, and with their statement, their actions followed. They substantiated what they said with their actions. Their actions proved what they said when they said, indeed our Rabb is Allah. So they showed their belief through their actions. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, this is how they were steadfast. They remained upon the dues of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stayed away from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned against. This is how we become people of steadfastness. And they persevered despite the obstacles, despite the whispers of shaitan, despite their cultures, despite their environment. They persevered remaining upon the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions their prizes. What does he say? رَبُّ الْعِزَّةِ وَالْجَلَالِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. For them, when they are passing away at a moment that is the most feared moment of their life. Death is something we fear, because we don't know whether we're from the people of Jannah or whether we're from the people of the hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of Jannah. Ameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that most feared moment showers upon us blessings. Blessings after blessings. The first of which is تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Look at the prizes for istiqamah. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. Angels are caused to descend upon them. This is prize number one. Prize number two, أَلَّا تَخَافُوا. And these angels are instructed to tell this dying person, لَا تَخَافُوا. Don't be afraid. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا. This is the third gift. And do not be sad. Do not be sad about that which you did. And do not fear that which is to come. SubhanAllah. Imagine this glad tidings at the time of death. Angels from Jannah descending upon you. This is enough. But this is not enough for those of istiqamah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says for them is extra. What is the extra? The message that they should not be sad about what they did. And they should not fear what is to come. La ilaha illallah. Ya Allah, we fear having disappointed you. And we fear being people from the hellfire. And here you telling us that we should not be afraid of that which is to come. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ. Prize number four. And be given glad tidings of Jannah. The Jannah that you were promised. How amazing is this? At the most feared moment in our life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers upon us blessing after blessing. It's all over. We're dying. In this world when we live, we might do a good deed, but we don't know if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted that good deed from us or is pleased with us. And we might be people that do good, but we don't know what our situation will be tomorrow. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. But this is the end. When you pass away, that is it. If you've passed, you've passed. And if you failed, wal'iyadu billah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. That's not... think about that. Let's concentrate on these rewards for those of istiqamah. Teaching us how important the concept of istiqamah is. Prize after prize. Angels descending. Us being given glad tidings of Jannah. And being told not to fear for what we did. And not to be sad for what we did. And not to fear that which is to come. Does it end there? No, O servants of Allah, not for the people of istiqamah. There's more, la ilaha illallah. For the people of istiqamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them further gifts. And that is, Allah instructing the angels to tell this dying person who is scared, نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. That don't be afraid. We were your protectors in the life that you lived. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. You're not alone. The friends that you think you're leaving behind, you're not. We were your friends. And we are your friends in the Akhirah, in the new life that you're entering now into. SubhanAllah. Imagine you think you're alone, but you've been told that you are never alone. And you will not be alone. How does that console the dying person? نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. What prize is this? We've lost count. Does it end there? No. There's more gifts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands them to inform this person that in the Jannah that this person is going to, they will have everything they merely desire. They don't have to practice any effort. Just desire it and you will have it. If you see a bird flying and you desire to eat it, it will be in front of you as you desire it. Fried, barbecued, roasted, as you prefer it. It will be there for you. This is Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us these glad tidings. That you're going to a place in which you will not have to speak. You just have to desire and it will happen as you desire. This is your prize. This is the prize for the people of istiqamah. And you might feel... What if I desire and desire and desire, and what I know is that in the life of this world, my desires become dried up. I've desired everything. I can't desire anymore. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you can no more desire, وَلَكُمْ مَا تَدَّعُونَ, then just ask. If you can no more desire, then ask. And you will be given what you want. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of Jannah and the people of Istiqamah. طيب. Does it end there? No, O servants of Allah. It doesn't end there. There's more gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all this from angels descending to you being told not to be sad for your past and not to fear for that to come. And being given glad tidings of Jannah and being told that these angels that are with you were your helpers in this world and your protectors in this world, and they are your same friends coming with you to the hereafter, and being told that you will have everything you desire, and being told that you will have everything you ask, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, nuzulam min ghafurir rahim, that all these gifts is just the welcoming, it's just the starter, it's not the main meal. La ilaha illallah. Nuzul in the Arabic language refers to that which you feed your guest when they come from a long journey and enter upon you. When they come to your house, you don't shove them straight on the dining table and give them the feast. We don't do that. We let them sit, catch their breath, offer them some water. Not so? All this which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has just said, for the people of Istiqamah, this is equivalent to the starter, the water you give your guest when they come from a long journey, when you are allowing them to rest so they are ready for the main meal. La ilaha illallah. Imagine what the main meal is. Imagine what other gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has for the people of Istiqamah. This subhanallah, a great gift. It requires great effort. It requires great effort. And just in case you feel, wallahi, this is impossible for me. These gifts are so many and my sins are so many. These gifts cannot be for me. This, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, it must be for the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam. It must be for the prophets of Allah. Just in case you think that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ended the ayah by saying, nuzulam min ghafurir rahim. It's a starter for you from the most forgiving, the most merciful. Meaning, those who get this prize were people who used to make mistakes. They used to make mistakes, but they sought forgiveness. Thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ended the ayah with Ghafoor al-Rahim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have ended it with any of His names and attributes, but He chose Ghafoor and al-Rahim. A gift from Ghafoor and al-Rahim to make you understand that they were people who were like yourself and myself. They weren't free from sin. They made mistakes, but they strived. And when they made a mistake, they turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they sought forgiveness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of Istiqamah. This is what it's about, O servants of Allah. And as we said earlier, al-jaza' min jinsi al-amal. That reward is proportional to effort. So if the reward is this grand, then how should the effort be? So we should strive with the waking of every day. We should strive with the waking of every day. And we should seek forgiveness from Allah if we make a mistake. And never ever feel depressed. And never ever feel that we are lost. And never ever feel that you don't have a chance. By Allah you do. By Allah we all do. As long as we are breathing, we have a chance of attaining these massive prizes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving and the most merciful. Never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even now, if you feel that I am inspired to become the best for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but I have so much baggage, don't ever lose hope. This is your time to turn to Al-Ghafoor and Al-Rahim, the most forgiving, the most merciful, and tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you have a strong intention to die upon istiqamah, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to assist you. And never forget the ayah in Surah Az-Zumar, the ayah which is considered the ayah of hope, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Don't forget the ayah of hope. The ulama of tafsir have said this is the ayah of hope, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, tell my servants, those who have wronged themselves, they have oppressed themselves with sin, they have transgressed the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tell them, لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله. Never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your sins, wholesale, quicker than the blink of an eye. إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, the most merciful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding, and make us a gathering that hears a good word and follows it, and make us a gathering that is forgiven upon our departure, and gather us many, many a time in this dunya, and gather us underneath His arsh on the day of qiyamah, and grant us our book of deeds in our right hands, and grant us the beautiful death we have just described, and grant us Jannah with Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen. Hada wallahu a'lam, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.